the young people go to school. So that's why I wrote about schools. So I wrote about cars. And mostly all the people, if they're not now, they'll soon be in love.
Yeah, this is a jumping little record I want my jockey to play. Roll over, Beethoven, I got to hear it again today.
You, monsieur, are the famous Simon Templar.
But what about Brother Vincent, supposing he notices something he thinks Clinton should know about?
Mr. Bond. James Bond.
Is there time before we leave? For lesson number 3.
Absolutely. There's no sense in getting off half-cocked.
Stir in some crushed ice, shake, strain, and pour. Top it off with one olive. Two.
Did you say something?
No. No, I said two. Two. You were perfect up until the olives. Two olives. That way you can see they can gently bounce up against each other.
Well, I'm afraid the spectacle of two olives gently bouncing up against each other is a pleasure I shall forego. One.
Oh, but you don't want to bust up a pair.
One. Oh, we played it tongue-in-cheek.
Two.
As I play most here is tongue-in-cheek, you know, because I really don't see myself as a hero. Although I play them as though, I play them as though, you know, it's all a joke.
A house with a door. One, two, three, four.
Great big curtain rings. I think they must have come out of a giant's house. I wonder what we could... Oh, I know what we can do with these. I'll be an owl.
Our aim, we were told, was to play one-to-one through the camera.
Up and down with your brush.
And it worked. I think that's why people remember it, because it was as though we were talking only for them.
It's Windy Miller. Hello, Windy.
Pew, pew, Barney McGrew, Cuthbert, Dibble, Grub.
Well, our animals aren't going to be happy, in fact, because they're going away on holiday too. They're going to spend it out in the country, but Lulu won't be there.
At this level, the plinth on which Nelson stands overhangs the column. I found myself literally hanging from the ladder with nothing at all beneath me. Once I'd reached the top of the column, the worst part began. I had to go down again, in a bosun's chair.
On the base.
You're coming down to join me?
Yes, I'm coming right down there now. OK? Do you feel all right?
Yeah, feels fine.
Good.
No, Shep, don't bite him. He's a nice little fella. Hey, that's enough.
Get down, Shep. Keep still, boy. Do as you're told. Come here. Get down, Shep. Behave yourself, or I'll cuff you round the ear.
John can never be alone, no matter...
Come, there's a tree. Quick. Have a sniff. Cut you some off. Wait a minute.
By Jove, I've just jumped out of this aeroplane at 50,000 feet. Get down, Shep.
Upside down! At 20,000 feet, I'm upside down!
Welcome to a special bank holiday edition of Cheggers Plays Pop.
How long did it actually take you to record the album?
I think it took between 2 and 3 years.
Oh, it's quite a long time, isn't it?
Yes.
Anyway, have you got any ideas what you want to swap it for?
I'm back again. 14 years I did here at the BBC. Swap shop. Cheggers Plays Pop. All sorts.
I happened to miss a bus one Christmas evening and went into a big London store and saw this toy bear sitting on the counter and nobody had bought it. It was the only one left. Took it home to my wife, and we lived near Paddington, so we decided to call it Paddington. One day I was sitting with a blank sheet of paper and a typewriter, started to write a story about it. That was the beginning of a book.
Mr. and Mrs. Brown first met Paddington on a railway station, which was how he came to have such an unusual name for a bear.
I'm laughing at clouds.
Rather based on my father. My father was a very polite man and always wore a hat in case he met somebody and had to have something to raise. And And Paddington's got a lot of him in it.
Good afternoon, he said. Can I help you?
There's Parsley. Sometimes Mr. Onion lets him ring the school bell. Hello, Parsley.
London is the place for me. London, that lovely city. You could go to France or America, India, Asia, Australia. You gotta come back to London City.
A sort of reticence and nervousness that perhaps the women might take over altogether. We might not present an acceptable face of cricket. And I actually cried as I walked out onto the pitch, and it was the most incredible feeling.
I have to be quick here. Rachel Flint has picked up and thrown, and what a good piece of fielding. Not a good piece of running between the wickets, though.
Come with the emotion of it all.
She just told me, Jana, you will do it. I believe you, one day you will do it.
She does.
First number 35, Valrora's Pie, 50-1. South Wales Police 14, Pontypridd 13. Blackburn Rovers 7. Nottingham Forest nil.
After our last programme, the editor of Final Score came along with a box. And when he opened the box and pulled out this trophy, I thought, that's absolutely made my day, because that is something that I've always thought, having watched the Sports Personality of the Year, I would love to have something like that as a souvenir of my career.
It was a two-piece deal, but it was kind of itchy, and somebody had to zip up the back. I had to fumble for a long time to get out of the suit. So, for example, you ask about going to the bathroom, somebody had to be there.
Were slaughtered with the others.
That is why we tried to kill Comrade Minister. That is why!
We'll need a team. Paul, you'll assess material damage. Helena, medical. Victor, scientific. Lowry, security. Alan, put Eagle 1 on the pad for immediate liftoff. Anne, Sandra, keep all communication systems wide open. Any response from that ship, relay it through to us. Connor, you take over.
Girls abroad with appealing shoulders and flowery dresses like wallpaper on the march.
Down here, war gets me that. Fine, that's all right too.
Not bad.
Nice face.
Yeah.
Good figure.
Yeah. Good teeth, too.
Eh.
What's the matter with you?
You two, where are you taking them tonight? Smithfield Market?
Are you happy? I mean, really, really happy, happy.
I'm fantastically happy.
I am. Oh, I know it's silly, but sometimes it worries me I'm so happy. I keep expecting something to come along and spoil it.
Daft thing. What could possibly do that?
It happens sometimes in an actor's life. If you're very, very lucky that something special turns up.
Steady, go!
And when I read Last of the Summer Wine, I thought, this is it.
Yes! This is it! This is the tree! You can see Tollgate Church!
I'm sorry, Gromit. And the fact is, I'm just crackers about cheese.
Oh, cracking toast, Gromit.
Oh, Will. Although our pride is at a shame,
I've found my thrill. Oh, we may be here. Oh, blueberry. When I find you,
New Guinea, New Jersey, New York, New Zealand. Where do you want to go, Chuck?
New Brighton.
I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife.
Well, go on. Kiss me.
Yeah, look what I've got! Hey, I've got a match for my fart dog. We saw it in this antique shop window on Nightingale Street. Oh, well, where are you going then, Jack?
I just wanted to see a man about a thing.
Where's my dog? Have you moved it?
No, Vera, I wouldn't have done only it was an emergency.
I bought my own dog, haven't I? I bought my own flaming dog.
Now, calm down, Vera, love. Calm down.
48 quid for my own dog.
48 quid, that miserable son's only give me 25.
I've never loved anybody else. Here, come on, say you've never loved anybody else.
I've never loved anybody else. Shall I go and get your slippers?
Please.
I wish that at that time I had been older so that I would have been able to have answered or spoke up for myself.
You move like a racehorse. You walk like a derby winner. You must let me help you. Introduce you to some friends of mine, some photographers, film people, television people. I could do wonders with you, little baby.
I am homosexual, irretrievably.
And why did you come here looking as you do?
Well...
Many people said, don't do that. You'll never work again. And I said, but it's not about homosexuality, actually. It's about the tenderness of the individual as opposed to the cruelty of the crowd, really.
I not used to be treated so well by a beautiful woman.
You're my future selves.
Yes.
Am I having a midlife crisis?
Why are you pointing your screwdrivers like that? They're scientific instruments, not water pistols.
Welcome aboard. Delighted you could join us. Captain Stryker at your service.
How do you do?
I'm the doctor and Miss Tinker.
I hold you responsible for Biggins, James.
It's this ragbag of fugitives from the debtor's prison that should concern us.
I remember a day when we did a lambing sequence all through the night in the dead ice cold of winter. Deep snow and endless frost.
We few! We happy few! We band of brothers!
But the removal of those grievances ought to precede the disarmament of the victim.
Right.
For such backbenchers, it's the curse of coalition politics. But the government is putting it down to the reality of an ageing and needful population. We've been shown that register, and it suggests that far from lessening, the threat is greater now than at any time for the last 10 years. The flood of allegations about Jimmy Savile's behaviour is now engulfing some of the many institutions he was involved with.
I think the decision to drop our story was a breach of our duty to the women who trusted us to reveal that Jimmy Savile was a paedophile.
Some walk by night, some fly by day. Nothing could change you, set and sure of the way. There is the sun. They sing their own sweet tune. Watch them when dawn is due, sharing one space.
Friday, moonlighting strangers who just met on the way.
Now, in the movie industry, of course, hype is good news if the film lives up to it. It's very bad news indeed if it doesn't. A morally uplifting parable about faith and redemption and how naive innocence can be mistaken for wisdom begins to unfold. Now it's okay. Now you can let the tears flow unchecked. I'll probably shed a couple myself as, for the very last time, I bow myself out to the accompaniment of Billy Taylor and the best theme tune on television. And more next week. Good night.
Hot favourite after wins in 1958 and 59. Number three, John Surtees on the MV4, rocketing away from Mike Hill. On his way to win his sixth TT and his third successive senior TT.
I don't set out with definite ambitions, I just try and do my best whatever I do.
In his Ferrari, John Surtees, number seven, going like a bomb and eventually leading the 10 cars still in the race.
When 20, 30, 40, 50,000 people screaming at the top of their lungs, I love you! It's so overwhelming, man. It's like, whoa!
I'm just a daydreamer, I'm walking in the rain.
You just don't expect to meet him personally.
I'm here
tonight.
Hi there.
To be honest with you, I've been touring about, I guess, three and a half years. And I'm really tired.
Will I feel like you're mine? And I see in your face I'm not wrong to have these feelings. I feel like you're mine. I've never known a time before that's had so many meanings.
Well, it's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Glenn Campbell.
I don't remember not having a guitar or a musical instrument in my hand. And then Dad bought a guitar for like $5.95, you know.
You just said, oh baby, how I love you.
I found out real quick that it was lighter than pulling a cotton sack or plowing.
But I'm gonna be where the lights are shining on me. Like a rhinestone cowboy. Riding out on a horse in a star-spangled rodeo.
I am a lineman for the county, and I drive the main roads.
I am a lineman for the county, and I what?
Drive.
And I drive the main roads. Yeah, looking in the sun for another overload. I hear you wire. I hear you ringing through the wire. Oh boy, that is just a what a great song.
And the Wichita lineman is still on the line.
What am I gonna do?
Now then, you have 55 seconds to beat the clock. Starting from now.
Life is the name of the game, and I wanna play the game with you.
Nice to see you.
To see you.
Nice! Yes, have a twirl, darling.
A gallon of scotch.
A gallon of scotch.
Cuddly toy.
A cuddly toy.
Didn't he do well?
Didn't he do well?
Oh, didn't she do well?
Tony Blair insists that weapons of mass destruction will eventually be found in Iraq. Well, it would be nice to see them,
Live from London, this is Strictly Come Dancing. Please welcome your hosts, Bruce Forsyth.
The moon.